Dear friends, this is episode number 6, Limitation Act. Last time, in the previous episode, I cited the decision AER 1964 Supreme Court 907, Ettiyavara Mathai versus Varki Varki. And the other decisions I have to cite today. Before that, I would like to point out that one of the viewers has pointed out that there is a mistake in one citation which I have given. That is MP Steel case. The correct citation, please note, 2015-7-SCC-5-8, which is a parallel citation 2015-2KLT-996 and 2015-KHC Kerala High Court cases 4317. Please correct it. There is a mistake, but I have given the name of the case, but please correct. Now we will go to see one aspect. I would like to read two or three sentences. 3.2b we have seen. I do not know whether I have read it out. In the case of set off, the date with the reference to which limitation is to be applied is the date of institution of the suit. Whereas, in the case of counterclaim, the relevant date is the date on which the counterclaim is made in court. Thus, even if the set-off is pleaded in respect of a claim barred by limitation on the date of the return state, the set-off shall be deemed to have been validly made if it is not barred on the date of suit. That is very important, very easy to understand that way. Now, in respect of counterclaim, in AER 1987 Supreme Court, 1395. The Supreme Court held that a counterclaim which is treated as a cross suit can be preferred before the time limited by the Limitation Act for filing the suit on the same cause of action, before the time limited by the Limitation Act for filing the suit on the same cause of action expires, and that the defendant could prefer the counterclaim even after filing the original return statement. The only limitation is that the claim on the date it was filed was not barred by limitation. This was followed, relied on by three judges in 2019-5 Kerala High Court cases, KHC 735, same as 2019-4 KLT 790 within brackets SC, both the cases. It is not seen reported, I could not find. The name of the case is Ashok Kumar Kalra, K-A-L-R-A, versus Wing Commander Surendra Agnihotri. Wing Commander Surendra Agnihotri. Yesterday, in the last episode, I said, a suit which is barred by limitation, really, the court decreed it. Whether the decree is a nullity and whether that question of nullity can be raised in execution. successfully. And I said that it is not so. It is an illegality and it can be corrected only in an appeal or in any other method which is known to law. Along with this, I will give two other instances. A suit was filed against a person as if he is a major. He was really a minor and no guardian was appointed for him to defend the suit. Decree was passed. And at the time when it was executed, by the time he has become a major, when he received the papers, he approached the executing court saying that at the time when the suit was filed and at the time when it was decreed, I was a minor. And therefore, the decree is null and void. Answer is, decree is null and void. Or an insane person, as if he is a sane person, he is made a defendant, while really he was insane. Then also the decree is void. And its validity, in the voidability can be challenged at any time and whenever and wherever it is sought to be enforced in execution or in collateral proceedings. A constitution bench decision in AER 1966 Supreme Court. 66 Supreme Court, 1457, paragraph 30. That is the right of the government to exercise its prerogative of imposing assessment on land. And it was held that there is no period of limitation. This decision was followed, relied on by another constitution bench. In AER 1968 Supreme Court, 1489, T.K. Lakshmana Iyer and others versus State of Madras and others, paragraph 12. T.K. Lakshmana Iyer and others versus State of Madras and others, paragraph 12. In the other decision, 66 Supreme Court, 1457, Constitution Bench. Please see paragraph 30. Then another decision, which I mentioned, that the right on expiry of the period of limitation, a money claim, only the right is, the remedy is barred, the right is not barred. Please note a decision, AER 1992 Supreme Court. 1815. Fixed deposit receipt, it can be adjusted, etc. Now, some more decisions. 2014 11 SEC 425 Draupadi Devi and others versus Union of India and others. Raising the plea of limitation after new facts were detected, after evidence, whether it is permissible. That was the question considered. And it was held that the High Court rightly applied Article 120 and held that the suit was barred by limitation. Paragraphs 72 to 75. Please note. 72 to 75. Then 2004-5 SEC. 2004-5 SEC. 272. Bajrang Lal Shivat Shiva Chardai, SHIV CHAR DRAI. Next word RUIA versus Shashikant R. Next word RUIA and others. And it was held that though the period of limitation prescribed in the Limitation Act precludes a plaintiff from bringing a suit which is barred by limitation, there is no such limitation so far as defense is concerned, which I mentioned earlier, but I am giving the latest citations on that point. Please note the same. Then next, AER 1992 Supreme Court 1815 Punjab National Bank and others versus Surendra Prasad Sinha. Supreme Court held Section 3 of the Limitation Act only bars the remedy but does not destroy the right. The right to debt continues to exist notwithstanding the remedy is barred. Where they, therefore, when the principal debtor did not repay the bank loan, the bank as creditor can adjust it at maturity of the fixed deposit receipts, which we have seen, same thing. Then next, five Kerala High Court cases, 426, a division bench. Section 3, duty of the court. Duty of the court, even in a case where the defendant had not specifically raised the question of limitation, it is obligatory on the part of the court to adopt the procedure under the CPC to decide the question whether the suit is barred by limitation. Then 2016 14 SCC 761, two judges, State of Gujarat versus Messrs. Kothari and Associates. Messrs. Kothari and Associates. Issue of limitation. Failure of the trial court to consider the issue in such case. A duty is cast on the court to consider this aspect of law, even its own initiative. And since it failed to do so, the appellate court can correct it. Then 2015 Supreme Court 2006 parallel citation 2015 6 SCC 412, Forshore Cooperative Housing Society Limited. Forshore Cooperative Housing Society Limited versus Praveen D. Desai and others. Section 3 clearly provides that every suit instituted, appeal preferred and application made after the prescribed period, subject to the provisions contained 4 to 24, shall be dismissed although limitation has not been set up as a defense. Same principle. Then 2014 KHC 416 Anthony CK versus Mathai Paikade. Even if it is not set up as a defense, the plea of limitation has to, as a defense, the question of limitation has to be considered by the court. Then 2014 Kerala High Court cases. 2014 Kerala High Court cases 149 Kurian E. Kalathil versus KSED. Same point. Then 2010-5 SEC 459 Oriental Aroma Chemical Industries Limited. Oriental Aroma Chemical Industries Limited versus Gujarat Industrial Development Corporation and another. Rationale behind law of limitation. It is law of limitation is founded on public policy. and when delay can be condoned, etc. All those things are mentioned. It is the point I would like to mention is that the rationale behind law of limitation is that the law of limitation is founded on public policy. That is a rationale. AER 2009 Supreme Court 2210 State Bank of India versus Messrs. BS Agricultural Industries. There it was considered along with Order 6, Rules 13. Limitation being a jurisdictional fact need not be pleaded. It is for the court to decide. Paragraph 11. Then 2005 4 SEC. 6-1-3. Salgaonkar versus Board of Trustees. A suit is ex facie barred by the law of limitation. In such circumstances, a court has no choice but to dismiss the same, even if the defendant intentionally has not raised the plea of limitation. See, intentionally has not raised the plea of limitation. Ex facie barred by limitation. Paragraph 20. Para 20-21. AER, in that case, AER 1964 Supreme Court 1336 was followed. 64 Supreme Court 1336 was followed. Then AER 1997 Supreme Court 2695. Three judges. Uttam Namdev NAMDEO Mahale MHLE versus Vital Dev. That is under the Mamlatdars Court Act. There was an eviction order. Under the Act, no specific period of limitation is provided. And it was held that in the absence of any specific limitation provided, necessary implication is that general law of limitation provided in the Limitation Act stands excluded. Order can be executed at any time. That is paragraph 4. There the AER 1969 Supreme Court 1297 was followed. And 1994 1 SEC 44 was followed. Was referred to. The next AER 1965 Supreme Court 241, three judges, C. Bipa Tumma and others versus Velashari Shankaranarayana Kadambolithaya and others, must be Kasaragod. Law of limitation is procedural law and the provisions existing on the date of the suit apply to it. Procedural law. Next is 2005-6 SEC 614 നർണേ രാമമൂർത്തി എൻ എ ആർ എൻ ഇ രാമമൂർത്തി വേഴ്സസ് രാവുള സോമസുന്ദരം ആൻഡ് അതേഴ്സ്. രാവുള സോമസുന്ദരം ആൻഡ് അതേഴ്സ്. There, this is a point. When limitation is a pure question of law, and from the pleadings itself, it becomes apparent that the suit is barred by limitation, then it is the duty of the court to decide limitation at the outset, even in the absence of a plea. That was along with Order 6 Rule 1, Order 7 Rule 11, Order 14 Rule 1, Order 14 Rule 2, Order 20 Rule 5 and Section 33. All those things were considered, and the paragraphs to be referred are Para 3, 5, 6, 7 and 8. I will read two or three sentences from paragraph 5. When limitation is a pure question of law, and from the pleadings itself it becomes apparent that a suit is barred by limitation, then of course it is the duty of the court to decide limitation at the outset, even in the absence of a plea. However, in cases where the question of limitation is a mixed question of fact and law, and the suit does not appear to be barred by limitation on the face of it, then the facts necessary to prove limitation must be pleaded, an issue raised, and then proved. This is a difference which you have to bear in mind. If on the face of the plaint and the document on which the plaintiff relies on to put forward his claim, the suit is barred, then even though no plea is raised by the defendant that the suit is barred by limitation, the court is bound to raise that plea. The court is bound to raise that question and decide it. Even if the defendant does not appear before court, even if he does not file a written statement, it is the duty of the court. And nevertheless, disregarding that a decree is passed, it can be corrected in appeal. No harm. So that if it is barred by limitation on the face of it, it is the duty of the court. If it is a mixed question of law and fact, something is to be proved in order to decide the question whether the suit is barred by limitation or not, then that fact has to be proved by the party who alleges the same. I gave an example. The plaintiff bases his claim on the basis of a promissory note or other document executed on, say, 1-1-2020. Last day of limitation is 1-1-2023. He filed the suit on 1-1-2024. On the face of the plaint, the suit is barred by limitation. But he pleads in the plaint that before the expiry of the period of limitation, namely 1-1-2023, the defendant made an acknowledgement, or in either case, if he pleads that defendant made part payment, either section 18 or 19 will apply, and a fresh period of limitation will begin to run from that date. And the defendant disputes that statement, then that is a matter for proof. The court cannot be blamed for not dismissing the suit on the ground that it is barred by limitation without the defendant raising it. It is pleaded in the plaint. Then if the court will take it as true, unless it is defended, it is controverted, then it becomes an issue. Then the court will decide it. That is to be distinguished from a situation where ex facie, on the face of it, the suit is barred by limitation, in which case it is a duty of the court to dismiss it, a suit which is really barred by limitation. These are the principles on the basis of which Section 3 is there. Now we will go to Section 4. We will have it in the next episode. Thank you very much.